Miss Price, how good of you to join us.
I'm so sorry we're late. My shift ran late at the diner, and then just sorry.
Let us proceed. One of you here is new to the Blackwell disciplinary process, and the other is all too familiar with it. Blackwell's code of conduct is built upon a foundation of mutual respect meant to foster an environment conducive to education and enrichment. When that respect is violated...
Reality check time. Yesterday did actually happen. I ditched school with Rachel Amber, and then Rachel really did start that fire. And that was after we actually agreed to run away from here. Right?
Are you paying attention to me, Chloe?
What?
Miss Price, the last time we met, an agreement was brokered. Do you recall what that was?
Don't get in trouble again?
Trouble is merely the byproduct, Miss Price. What's at issue is your attitude. We agreed that you would rededicate yourself to becoming an exemplary Blackwell citizen.
We did?
In the event that you were unable or unwilling to do so, we also agreed that it would become pertinent to reassess your future status at the Academy. Despite all this, you engaged in the following actions yesterday. Insubordinate language. Disregarding posted signs about trespassing on the stage. Implications of possible drug-related activities.
What does that mean?
Yes, what does that mean?
It means Miss Price has developed a reputation as a user of marijuana. And I would strongly recommend you take a careful look through her room at home. Shall I continue? Attempting to sabotage the academic goals of one of our top students, Victoria Chase.
Academic goals like doing her own homework? Because I thought Blackwell had a zero tolerance policy on plagiarism.
Excellent suggestion. Stricter punishment for students who violate Blackwell's code of conduct is next on our agenda.
Now hold on. Why is Chloe being punished for someone else's plagiarism?
The infraction involved both students. Victoria will be reprimanded as well.
Yeah, I bet.
For her plagiarism, Miss Chase might have been suspended. Might have. If Mr. Prescott, Nathan Prescott, hadn't spoken to me on Victoria's behalf. And we have witnesses saying Miss Price was also involved in a bullying incident of the same Mr. Prescott.
If involved means not sticking out my neck for Blackwell's richest ass child, I didn't realize that was a crime.
Your lack of awareness does not absolve you of anything, Miss Price.
Say what you will about my daughter, but she is not a bully.
Maybe you should be talking to Drew instead of me. You know, the guy who actually did what you're accusing me of.
Mr. North's situation requires sensitivity. It will be handled separately.
Mom, you know this is all bullshit, right?
I'm beginning to suspect that myself.
I am sorry you feel that way, but your daughter's misbehavior is real and serious. And yet, even with your prodigious disciplinary record, Miss Price, we needn't discuss any of it.
We needn't?
No, because you severed your relationship with Blackwell the minute you left school grounds without permission.
What does that mean?
It means you forced my hand. This is a consequence of your actions, Chloe. I have no choice but to...
I made her do it.
What?
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 What? Yesterday was all me. My idea. I was having a bad day. I needed to blow off some steam, and I took it too far. Chloe tried to talk me out of it. I've been down that road, she told me.
You're better than this. But I wouldn't listen. See, Chloe was afraid I'd get in trouble or hurt, so she came with me. But only to keep me safe. I'm just sorry you got caught up in it, Chloe. That you allowed me to drag you down to my level. Can you forgive me?
Yeah, sure. We're cool.
Thank you. I'll make it up to you. I promise.
Chloe, is this true?
It's true.
Totally not true. She really is an amazing actress.
Miss Price?
Fine, yes. It was her idea, but it's not like she kidnapped me. We were in it together.
Miss Amber, based on what you've just told me, I have grounds to punish you. Are you sure what you've told me is the truth?
Yes.
This can't be the full story, Rachel.
Ray.
Just to be clear, Miss Amber, you're sure Chloe Price didn't coerce you or...
Coerce her?
I'm just trying to get to the bottom of why someone like Rachel...
Oh, I think we're clear, Principal Wells. Someone like Rachel, but not my daughter.
Excuse me?
Do you have a list of students you assume the worst about?
Go, Mom.
You have no right to treat Chloe this way. This is because she's on financial aid, isn't it? Oh, I get it. This is about Blackwell's money troubles. Will you be dragging every other scholarship student into your office today as well? Tell me, will unfounded rumors about drug use also be mentioned, or is that only reserved for my daughter?
Damn.
Let's all just calm down.
After everything she's been through in the last 2 years, you should be ashamed of yourself.
Miss Price.
Mrs. Price.
Mrs. Price, I appreciate your position, but I assure you, it is only your daughter's past behavior that has led us here today.
I understand, Mr. Wells. There is no doubt that Chloe's behavior must improve. But given what we've just learned about the negative influence she was under, I hope you will allow her just one more chance.
Miss Amber, I am as surprised as I am disappointed in you.
I understand.
This being your first infraction in no way reduces its severity. Still, we will not be suspending you at this time. But you have squandered our trust. You will no longer be my administrative assistant first period. And you will no longer be involved in Blackwell's performance of The Tempest.
No.
What? Are you insane?
Your discipline is still pending, Miss Price.
Ray. She loves that show. Since this is her first infraction, don't
Mr.
you think,
Amber, I don't tell you how to run the district attorney's office. Please don't tell me how to run my school. There's a reason we have understudies for all circumstances, accidental and deliberate. I'm sure your understudy.
Victoria Chase.
How fitting. Yes, I'm sure Victoria Chase will do fine.
That is
such... What was that, Miss Price?
Chloe is upset for her friend, but we are both grateful that she is not going to be unduly blamed for what happened.
There is plenty of blame to go around. Chloe's future at Blackwell will be discussed next, unless you had something to add first, Miss Price.
No way is Rachel missing the play for me. But thanks to her acting skills, I'll have to go down in flames if I want to fix this.
Get your head out of your ass, Wells.
Chloe!
You seriously think yesterday was Little Miss Sunshine's idea?
Miss Amber has accepted her responsibility.
Don't you have the slightest idea how this works? You don't wake up one morning and decide to be an outlaw. You need priors. You need training.
Rachel confessed. Are you calling her a liar?
Wells, you should confess to falling for her crap. I don't blame you, though. She's one hell of an actress.
You don't have to do this. It's okay. Really.
How about you don't take credit for my shit? You don't see me claiming I did my homework, do you? Because that's your stupid thing.
Chloe, this can't be you. Apologize this instant.
Fine. I'm sorry for bullying Nathan. But if you had to look at that smug face as often as I do...
I've heard enough. Rachel, you were clearly trying to cover for your classmate. I appreciate the motive, but I appreciate honesty more. Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
You will not be removed from the play.
Was that so hard?
Thank you.
And Miss Price, I came into today's meeting planning to suspend you for the rest of the school year, with a chance for reinstatement in the fall.
And now?
You are expelled.
What? No.
I will have Skip Matthews escort you to clean out your locker. You may wait outside my office until he arrives. That is all. Good day, Mrs. Price, Mr. and Mrs. Amber.
Ray.
Come on, Chloe.
I'm sorry. Nothing to be sorry about. Meet me at the junkyard later? You bet.
I didn't get the chance to introduce myself. I'm Joyce.
Mrs. Price.
I'm Rose. This is James. I'm sorry we had to meet like this.
No, I'm sorry. I'm sure for you this is an unusual circumstance.
We really should be going. Nice to meet you.
Mom,
I'll see you in the parking lot.
Hey, Chloe. I'm supposed to walk you out.
Just you and me, eh, Skip?
Fuck 'em. Bunch of fascists. Hey, just wanted to say, it sucks what is happening to you.
Thanks, Skip.
You're gonna be missed.
I don't really care about any of this shit. Except my secret stash. Might as well grab my emergency joint while I'm here. I had big plans for adding to this collage. Oh well. Wonder who will grace this space after me. Trusty keeper of my graffiti pens. You've served me well.
finally, what I actually came here for. Jackpot. Wait. What the hell? Damn it, Justin. Fuck every inch of this place. I wish I could tag it from floor to ceiling. But with Skip watching me...
Bathroom. Then I'm out. Cool?
Okay. But try to make it fast, will you?
Later, Skip.
Later.
Looks like David's here. Another letter to Max. That I'll never send. At least Journal Max won't abandon me the way Real Max did. I guess these stage lights are for the Tempest. What could the Tempest use more of? All that's left is to get arrested.
Hey, Elliot.
What brings Chloe Price to school on a Saturday morning? Nothing good, I bet.
I was expelled.
Wait, really? Holy shit!
I know. I'm surprised it took this long, too.
Do you want a hug?
Okay. Thanks.
Was Rachel Amber involved?
Yeah.
And let me guess, did she get off scot-free?
Well, yeah. But she tried to cover for me.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, what are you doing here?
I thought I should come early to grab tickets. For the Tempest? You said we might see it together.
Right. Good call.
Did you get my text about hanging out afterwards?
Yeah. I mean, I'm not really big on making plans, but maybe.
Cool. Sounds good.
I better go. My mom is waiting to stick her attack mustache on me. Her boyfriend. Don't worry about it. See you around, Elliot.
Yeah. Later.
It's about damn time.
David, please.
Chloe, your mother and I have been talking.
Can we do this later? I don't think I can handle another fight right now.
And who do you expect to handle things for you? Your mother?
I don't need a conversation. Not with Sergeant Asshat here. I just need some space.
Do not use that language with your mother.
Or what, David? What will you do?
You do not want to test me.
Chloe, we just want to help.
I'm sure.
I know what you did. The money in my purse. I appreciate it, Chloe. But where did it come from?
Does that really matter?
I can't turn a blind eye.
We need money, Mom.
I'm providing as best I can. I appreciate what you've done. I'm just worried about you, Chloe.
This is so pointless. I don't understand what we're doing here.
Maybe if you try listening to me, instead of fighting me about everything, you might actually learn a thing or two.
What? Like how to have no job? Or how to be a soldier?
Soldiers put family and future above self and now. Getting kicked out of school? That's what losers do.
You had a scholarship, Chloe. Do you know what that means? What kind of opportunity you gave up? Do you want to work at the diner?
There's nothing wrong with waiting tables, Mom.
Chloe, I'm proud to wait tables because it means you can be whatever you want to be. But what is that, Chloe? What do you want?
Maybe. I don't know yet.
Maybe you've had long enough to figure it out. Right now, what I need most of all is for the two of you to start getting along.
Chloe, I care about Joyce very much. I'm willing to forgive you for the incident yesterday. If you
improve your attitude going forward.
Incident? What incident?
Chloe was incredibly out of line. She insulted me, swore at me. But with an apology, I'm willing to start over.
Sure. Reset button pressed.
I am glad to hear it. From now on, I will be assisting your mother in a few areas, like making sure that you are no longer abusing drugs or alcohol.
Mom.
Chloe, I'd like you to empty your pockets and place all your belongings on the trunk of the car.
What the fuck?
If we are going to start over, we have to know that you are not abusing drugs. If you're not, you should be eager for the chance to prove it.
Mom, I don't need more discipline from you. I need my mom.
I know, Chloe, and I'm sorry, but David feels...
Joyce.
We feel this is the best way to start fresh.
Let's go, Chloe. Quit stalling.
Fine. You want to see my shit so badly? You know what sucks even worse than invading someone's privacy? Doing it for no reason.
You're awfully smug for someone who just got kicked out of school.
Chloe, I'm sorry. Can you forgive me?
I forgive you. You were under a terrible influence.
I just worry about you, but that's no excuse.
Joyce, you can't start apologizing now. This will only encourage her.
That's enough out of you, David. We need to start treating each other better. And that means all of us. We need a new beginning. A new chapter. One that will involve the three of us together.
What does that mean?
We both agree that the best thing for everyone at this stage is for me to move in.
No fucking way!
Chloe, after everything that's happened, I'm at a loss. I need help.
Exactly. We need a firmer hand steering this ship.
Talk to me, Chloe. Tell me what you're feeling.
You're trying. I get it. I swear, I do. And I've been making it harder for you. But this is not the answer.
It's the only answer I have, Chloe.
In a million years, I never thought you'd choose David over me. I'm sorry I took that for granted.
I'm not choosing anyone over anyone else. It's about the three of us having a home together.
It'll be better than you think, Chloe. Once everything's running smoothly, you'll see what a stable home can be like.
There is no home. Not if he's there.
Chloe.
Let her go. She'll come home as soon as her tantrum is over.
How do you know which way is up when your whole life has been turned upside down? Blackwell's done with me. I can't go home anymore. Is this junkyard all I've got left? Ugh. This thing is a mess, but maybe I can fix it. No, not going over there. What are you trying to hide under their hood? Here we go, the pick of the litter. Thank you.
This thing needs more love than I can give right now. In the meantime, maybe I can spruce it up a bit.
While an escape hatch could be nice, I should probably cover over this massive hole. Probably a good idea to cover over this with something. Maybe there's another light bulb I can put in here. Okay, let's see what else this trash heap has to offer. Light the way, Robobulb. Cigarettes. Shit. What do I want to tell my fellow sailors of the seven trash heaps? Got it. Pretty sure this isn't what Rachel meant when she talked about going to LA to be a model. Then again, it's probably not what this person meant either. You're a long way from the country club, guy. This might make the perfect cover for that torn seat. Thank you.
You're a long way from the beach. I always wanted a pet snake. Instead, I got David. Fuck everything. I used to love opening up the diner with Mom before school. I guess those days are now officially over. You should cover that life-endangering floor hole quite nicely. You can hang here, but I get to pick the tunes. Okay? Good talk. This thing looks like a rusted out shopping cart. Probably drives like one too. That's if it ever does drive, which seems questionable. Still, how sweet would that be? Yeah?
Bryce, it's Frank.
Oh. Hey, Frank. What's up?
Yeah, just checking in to see how you're doing.
Really?
No. Listen, we've got some business to discuss. Where can we meet?
What about? Oh, like drugs?
Bryce.
I'm hanging out in the junkyard, north of town.
A junkyard? That's great. Stay there, I'll see you soon.
Okay. And Frank? I'm not in trouble or anything, right?
I don't know. Did you do anything you should be in trouble for?
Like, in general, or to you?
I'll see you soon.
Time for a hard-earned smoke break. You only get one chance to make a first impression. The eye sees all.
Looking good, Robobulb. Does Principal Wells eat pizza with a fork and knife? I knew there was something off about that guy. Shit. I slept all day. What the hell? Dad? I wonder if it burned like this the day it happened. Dad, what are we doing here?
Amazing, isn't it? I can't look away.
Sure.
Don't pretend you're not mesmerized too. See? You're so drawn to it, you don't even realize the danger.
Danger?
Fire blinds us, just like darkness. But darkness blinds with absence, with loss.
What does fire blind with?
Beauty. But sometimes, there's a greater beauty yet to come.
Incredible.
Fire is jealous, Chloe. It wants all the beauty for itself. That's why you need to be careful.
Careful of what?
Of getting burned.
Hasn't anyone ever told you not to fall asleep with a lit cigarette? You could start a fire. So, are you gonna invite me in, or what?
I love giving rides to strange drifters. Hop in.
Thanks. You've been busy.
It's nothing. Just some junk I found lying around.
A pirate flag? A cool blue light? Holy shit. The all-seeing eye.
Figured it can't hurt to have the Illuminati on our side for whenever shit goes down.
Always thinking ahead. Chloe, this is incredible. I can't believe you found us an escape vehicle already.
That's the hope. But it doesn't exactly drive yet.
You'll figure it out. And while you're at it, we're also gonna need some money. You know, to buy stuff.
Uh-huh. Car and money? Anything else you'd like?
Luckily, there's no rush.
True. And no Blackwell.
Holy shit. That Wells meeting. I'm so sorry. I can't believe he actually expelled you.
Why not? No reason to prolong the inevitable.
It's definitely Blackwell's loss. You covering for me was amazing. I don't know how to thank you.
Whatever. You tried to cover for me, too.
Tried and failed. I guess we know who the better liar is.
Or maybe my lie was the one he wanted to believe.
At least Wells has no idea what really went down with us last night. Shit got pretty wild.
Last I checked, you're the one who went all Puff the Manic Dragon on that tree last night.
What were you thinking? I was angry. I didn't expect the whole stupid park to go whoosh. But come on, doesn't accomplice sound way cooler than accessory after the fact?
Is that the official Arcadia Bay DA's opinion? Accomplice it is. I'd be way happier going to jail than having to live at home with Dictator David. He announced his plans to move in this morning.
Oh, Chloe, that's awful. I'm so sorry. You know what we both could use? Therapy.
Therapy.
You start. Kick back and tell me what's bothering you.
Well, Doc. There's this dildo with a mustache who's been dating my mom, and now he thinks he's moving in with us. How do I stop him?
That's a hard one. I'm not sure there's really anything you can do.
Then what the hell am I talking to you for?
Just because you can't stop him doesn't mean you don't fight back. The resistance begins now.
All right.
You're going to need a new nickname to mark your enemy. What have you got?
He's a step douche, because he's inserting himself where he doesn't belong. Also, he's a douche.
Poetic. May I also suggest stepladder?
Why stepladder?
Because he climbs on your mom every night.
Ew!
And pretty soon, they'll be stepping down the aisle.
What the hell kind of therapist are you?
Sorry. It's called shock therapy. Highly controversial.
So, my new friend, who everyone thinks is perfect, did something batshit fucking nutso last night. What do I do?
This perfect friend of yours, who I'm assuming is also an exceptional beauty, sounds like she may have been inspired by someone new in her life. Perhaps this friend of yours, who, I reiterate, must be just stunning, needed someone in her life to teach her.
How to steal wine from yuppie picnickers?
How not to give a fuck. Because she was tired of having to give so many fucks all the time.
That makes sense. I've been booted from school, and I'm not entirely sure what to do about it.
You mean how to cope with your feelings of anger and disappointment?
No. I mean how to express my feelings of intense joy.
Uh-huh. Do you think you might be taking this a little too well?
You tell me. I'd say I'm exceptionally well-adjusted.
I'd bet my therapist's license that no one's ever called you that before.
Touché, Doc. That was actually somewhat therapeutic. Thank you.
It's always a pleasure delving into the mind of Chloe Price.
And now it's your turn. Tell me all about what it's like being daughter of Arcadia Bay's most famous scumbag.
It sucks.
Too blunt? Sorry. I do that sometimes.
Nah, I'm just... I don't know. Can we talk about something else?
Of course. I kind of fixed the truck a bit. That might mean I have life skills, something I've really tried to avoid. Upshot, I'm closer to becoming a car thief.
That's pretty badass. Do you think there's a point when you've been acting so much that you don't even have your own personality anymore? You're just whatever you think other people want you to be.
I think you have a personality.
I wasn't talking about me. My dad doesn't really exist. You saw him in Wells' office. The whole thing is a performance. And now I'm starting to feel like everything in my life is bullshit. But he's still my dad. How can I make sure I don't end up like him?
You couldn't be like him even if you wanted to. You're too awesome.
The fact that you believe that makes me feel better. Shit. It's time for the play. As if my life didn't have enough drama in it. Good luck. You know you're never supposed to tell an actor good luck before a show? It's bad luck.
How is telling someone good luck bad luck?
You're supposed to say, break a leg.
That's dumb.
Hey, I was thinking that after the show, maybe we could go do something. Just you and me.
Something criminal?
Criminally fun.
I'm in. Wait, you forgot your bag.
It's for you. Just a little survival kit for your new life on the lam. Drive safe, Chloe.
Hello, Junk Shack. Time to check out Rachel Amber's mystery bag. A bag full of clothes. Yes, I need those. Nothing like an abandoned shack in the middle of a junkyard to make a girl feel like exploring a new wardrobe. Frank's outside. I should get going if I'm done changing.
That's the woman we saw with Rachel's dad. Weird.
Yo, Frank! It's Chloe. I don't know the secret password, man. Is the password drugs?
Price, get your ass in here.
Dude, it smells like piss in here.
Shut up.
You have a rough night or something?
Every night's a rough night. I've got a notebook in the back somewhere. Go get it for me, would you?
Who is that woman? Ah! God. Jeez, man.
Get my notebook, Price. Then we'll talk.
No, I'm fed.
Gross. Got it. Guess Frank subscribes to the hiding in plain sight philosophy of drug stashing. Wait, Frank got a puppy? For real? Rachel, the therapist, would have a field day with this. Shit. The mill burned down. Jeez. That's an expensive dog. So Frank's a fellow survivor of Black Hell. Who knew? Fight the power. Oh, man. I hope Argus and Bowser are okay. It's always hard to tell what Frank's thinking. Sorry, Frank. I didn't know it was your RV when I wrote that. Frank must be spending hundreds of dollars on this dog. Do I really want to see Frank's bedroom? Whoa!
Hey there. It's okay, little guy.
Aw, shit! Pompidou, get up here!
Pompidou.
You little killer.
Is this what I think it is? Ugh, shit. I'm in the red. Time to find out what Frank wants to discuss. Swingy, flippy instrument of death. Wow. That pillow is definitely dead. A throne fit for Frank, because Frank finally gave up on the stake. Frank and his BFF. That's adorable. Is this it?
Have a seat.
Pompadour, huh? That's one badass name for a dog.
It's French.
Does it mean, like, tough guy or something?
Do I look like I speak fucking French?
Okay, so who was that woman?
What woman?
The one I saw coming out of your RV.
Oh yeah, I meant to introduce you. Her name is Mind Your Own Fucking Business.
Rachel would want to know more. I bet I can convince Frank it's harmless to tell me. Dude, I'm just curious. What's the big deal?
Idiot. I make money by being discreet.
No shit, Frank. You think I don't know about hiding things from other people? I'm a teenager.
Come on, Price. I gotta protect my clients. Happy customers are the foundation of a good business.
Hey, so, I had this dream the other night about a cloud that swallowed Arcadia Bay.
You too?
See? We're a lot alike, Frank. We've got shit in common.
Sure, I guess. So why are you so hung up on this chick?
Come on, Frank. This is Arcadia Bay. Gossip is all we have to keep us from hanging ourselves out of boredom.
I don't know.
Frank. Talk, and I'll get my mom to make you something special.
Like what? How about that firehouse chili of hers?
You got it.
The woman you saw. Her name's Sarah. Showed up a few weeks ago, causing all kinds of trouble for all sorts of people.
Like who?
It's a little out of your league, okay?
But what kind of trouble, exactly?
Forget about it, Chloe. Shouldn't have opened my mouth.
Thanks for telling me.
Whatever. You hear the mill burn down?
Yeah. I heard some stuff about it.
Crazy. My friend Damon runs the place. He lost a lot of money last night.
How about you? Did you lose anything in the fire?
No. But I'll probably get pulled into whatever shit Damon's dealing with right now. Lately, he's been doing some stuff that I don't like. But I don't seem to have much leverage with him like I once had. Anyway, you and I have shit to discuss.
Is this about the buck 75?
What?
The money that I owe you?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, I don't give a shit about that. Wait, do you have it?
Give me like another week. I don't have enough right now.
I wonder if I'll ever get tired of your crap. You're lucky you're the least of my problems. Open my notebook. Last page. Should be some entries for a kid named Drew. You know him?
Drew North? Yeah, he's... Holy shit. That's a lot of money.
Drew runs Oxy for Damon. Apparently football players eat it like candy.
That's smart, I guess. It pays well?
Go Bigfoots. Problem is, Drew owes a grant, and he's not answering my calls. You know what's going on with them?
No, I never talked to him. Or his type.
No one's just a type, Price. Anyway, here's the job. I'm taking you to Blackwell. Go to Drew's room, find the money, and I'll meet you to pick it up. Can you handle that?
Yeah, of course, but what's in it for me?
Idiot, you still owe me.
So, if I do this, then we're good?
That, and I'll do even better. I'll give you a 10% cut of the money.
Okay. Yeah, sure. I'll do it.
What's the matter?
It might be a little tough. I'm not supposed to be at Blackwell. I got expelled this morning.
Congratulations. Still easier for you to go on campus than for me. If you can't even do this, Price.
$100 closer to leaving Arcadia Bay. With a bit of cash and the truck fixed, Rachel and I could really do it. We could leave for good. I'll do it.
Good deal.
Didn't think I'd be back this soon. Well, here goes nothing. Better. They're just too high risk.
What are you doing here? Aren't you supposed to be at home, thinking over your endless list of questionable decisions?
Dude, why do you care about my questionable decisions?
It offends me when intelligence is wasted.
Did Evan just call me intelligent? Damn straight.
Wow. Evan looks really ridiculous.
Chloe?
Uh-huh.
I've learned something about myself recently. Something that I think you might understand. I've learned that if I'm passionate about something, it's probably the right thing to care about. Forest fires, for example. You were the only person who signed my petition. I mean, seriously signed it.
That's pretty sad. I'm a low bar, but did you really expect people to care?
People are so eager to pass on responsibility to anyone else so that they can live comfortable, unworried, and ultimately meaningless lives. You see what happened?
Looks like you were right. Go, Evan. You're a hero of the people.
I know you feel like I do. About different things, I'm sure. But you only give a shit about what you give a shit about. I like that. Anyway, you're not supposed to be here. You should leave.
Come on.
Evan's subject for the day. Better you than me, Bird. Blackwell Academy. Conserving water since never.
You shouldn't be on campus, Chloe.
Hey, Steph.
Whoa. Hey, Calamastia. Your shirt looks like the tea leaves they used to tell people's fortunes.
How's my future looking?
Bright and sunny.
Surprised to see me on parole?
I told you Wells was out to get you. That text was a rare courtesy, by the way. I don't normally get involved in other people's dumb decisions.
Thanks for trying, but skipping yesterday was totally worth it.
Skipping with Rachel Amber does have an appeal.
Well, yeah.
So, what are you doing here?
I'm just picking up something from somebody. It's for a friend.
Now I'm really curious.
What are you doing? What's all this stuff?
I'm prepping for the Tempest show tonight. I'm the stage manager.
Oh, right. I think I knew that.
Honestly, the show's really good. It's worth seeing.
I'm sure it is.
Obviously, Rachel's fantastic, but everyone else is pretty impressive, too. You get to see a totally different side of everyone, especially the guys.
Okay. I'm intrigued. Go on.
Like, Hayden's so annoying, but when he puts on that crown, he's actually very princely. And Nathan is Caliban? There's so much depth there.
Right. Depth. Yeah, well, good luck with all of that. Maybe I'll see you later.
Oh, hey. I wanted to ask you something.
Shoot.
I've been planning to make a move on Rachel, but not if you two were together.
Make a move?
So, are you? I mean, that's Rachel's business. Or maybe yours and Rachel's business. But if you feel comfortable telling me...
I don't know. It's It's confusing.
Yeah, I can imagine. You ever want to talk to me, Chloe, you know you can, right?
I'll see you later, Steph.
Have fun storming the castle.
You shouldn't be on campus, Chloe.
Locked. Figures. Looks like my options are become a master lockpicker or swipe someone's keys. Bingo. If only those keys were unsupervised. What's Samuel working on? The sprinklers?
You shouldn't be on campus, Chloe.
If Samuel's working on the sprinklers, some damage here might get his attention. But Evan is right there.
Hey!
Shit! I wanted you to go the other way. Like, as far as possible, the other way. Time for a fresh start. Here we go. Gotcha.
Oh, perfect.
You're welcome. Awesome. Now I just have to wait for Samuel to turn on the... That works. Sorry, Samuel. All right, time to find Drew's room. No time like the present.
Chloe?
Hey, Skip. How's it going?
Not that it isn't great to see you and all, but what are you doing here? Didn't you just get expelled?
Relax. I'm just visiting a friend.
I can't... I really can't just let you go in.
I'm going inside, dude. You're just gonna have to let this slide.
I don't think I can. In fact, I think I have to ask you to state your official business or else vacate Blackwell property.
I hate to do this to Skip, but I've got to get inside. Maybe if I make him really uncomfortable, he'll feel guilty and let me pass. What's my official business? I'm going to the bathroom. Is that what you wanted to hear? Is that interesting to you?
What? No. No, it's my job to ask, Chloe.
Your job is creepy, then. Which makes you kind of a creeper.
Oh, it's not like that. Do you know what Wells would do to me if I didn't, you know, patrol?
You know Wells doesn't really respect you, right? You're just a rent-a-cop who needs a haircut.
I thought we were friends. Where is this coming from?
I thought we were friends, too. But when the man comes down on you, you come down on me. Is that it?
Look, look, look! I am really sorry, Chloe. I'm just so confused right now.
You're sorry? You just looked at my tits. You did. You stared right at them.
Oh, shit. I don't know what to do.
Seriously, my uterus is on fire, dude.
What?
Is that descriptive enough?
I don't want to know.
En fuego utero, Skip. En fuego utero.
I don't know what to say. I'm so sorry.
Matthews.
I'm here.
I've gotten reports of an unknown vehicle in the parking lot.
Thank God. Oh, I'm on it. I won't tell Wells. Do what you have to do, okay? I won't tell anyone.
All right, which one is Drew's room? Guess I'll never see my name on one of these. I wouldn't have made it to senior year anyway. Elliot Hampton's room. Wonder what he's up to right now. Elliot does work really hard. I guess I'm happy for him. Elliot's kind of preppy in his own way. Maybe he does belong at Blackwell. I knew Elliot did well in class, but I didn't realize he was here on a full ride. I've never been able to get Elliot to play for me. I guess he's either really good or really bad. Elliot's mom seems nice. Lucky Dana. Warren Graham is such a... There's way less porn here than I would have thought. That's not half bad. Okay. Dark. Who is it that Elliot's writing about? Elliot is way more artistic than I thought. Wait. Are these about me? What the fuck, Elliot? Wow. I remember this show. Crazy that Elliot would hold on to this picture. The world breaks everyone, and afterward, some are strong at the broken places. Why does that make me sad? It's been so long since Elliot and I actually went to a concert together. Elliot likes to write poetry about me, eh? What do I want to say in response?
Emotional. Loyal. Introverted. Odd. And talented?
Yep, definitely Drew's room. Good. Drew's not here. Okay, if I were Drew, where would I hide my money? Bet the dinner choices are steak or steak. Holy shit, Drew. A college scholarship? No wonder you're so into football. I didn't realize Drew was this good at sports. I bet he can't wait to get out of Arcadia Bay. Frank wasn't lying. Looks like Drew sells happy pills to his fellow meatheads. So many folks are shit out of luck around here. At least Drew has some prospects. Too bad I lost my release form. I was really looking forward to running all those sweaty laps. Durgeron. Yeah, that fucker's dead. Looks like Mikey's been staying here with Drew. Mikey's figures. Playing that game yesterday was actually fun. They look so happy. Oh, man. Looks like Drew's dad is having a hard time. Is the money in there? All right. Guess I have to crack a 4-digit code. Yes! This is kind of fun. Ah. Oh. Did little Drew beat you up too? Jackpot. I'm kind of good at this. Okay, got the money. Time to bust out of here. Hey, Elamon.
Chloe? What are you doing here?
No reason, just roaming the halls.
Were you wanting to play more tabletop games?
Bro, we gotta go. What are you doing here? Doesn't matter. Mikey, get your stuff, let's move.
Drew, relax. Slow down.
Shit!
You're making me think you're nervous about something.
Drew, what's going on?
Don't worry about it. Stay in here and don't say anything, little brother. Whatever you do, don't open the door.
You know what's going on?
Damon, you shouldn't have come here. School's not the place for this.
Really? Where is the place to collect my fucking money?
Shit!
I told you, I don't have it. Sales are down, man. Nobody wants to get high right now. But look, it's spring season. We just started 2-a-days. Those are gonna kill us. I'll be able to sell all the oxy you've got.
Drew, you owe me $1,000. Where is it?
I said I don't have it right now.
I heard about your dad's job, by the way. Tough times.
Yeah.
Bet $1,000 would mean a lot to him right now. Where's my money, Drew?
I don't know what you expect me to do. I can't just make money appear out of thin air.
I want my fucking money!
You don't have to hit me, man. I'm gonna...
Where is it?
Please! Just give me one week.
You're just going to lie there? I thought football players were supposed to be tough. Sorry to have to do this, kid. No one steals from me. No one.
Fuck. Fuck.
Stop. It's okay. I've got your money.
Ah, I didn't realize we had an audience. Hey, Mikey. Okay. Who the hell are you?
Frank sent me. To collect.
That's what Frank was going on about? Wait. Are you the bitch who tuned up Sheldon?
That guy at the mill? He was an asshole. He kept harassing me. He needed to get the message.
Frank was right about you. Let's see the cash.
We need that!
It's all here. Mikey, you need to help your big brother. Help him understand that I take this shit seriously.
Come on. Mikey's got nothing to do with this, man.
You help your brother understand that if he steals from me again, I'm coming back here and I'm going to break his knees. Thanks, kid. Tell Frank I owe him one.
We needed that money. You just screwed us over.
Are you crazy? That guy could have killed you.
You don't know anything about this situation. It's none of your business.
I was trying to help. Damon wasn't going to stop until he had that money.
You didn't solve anything. You just put us back where we started. Mikey, I gotta look at your arm. Just leave us alone.
Look, I'm sorry.
Sorry doesn't get our dad off the streets, does it?
We'll be okay.
day has been so messed up.
Chloe Price presents Firewalk, Laser Light Spectacular.
What's up, Mr. Keaton?
Why, if it isn't the muse of the Blackwell Drama Department.
Tell me, young lady, do you still believe true love exists?
Sure, I think so. But it's a lot weirder and scarier than poets and pop songs make it out to be.
You might be surprised, my dear. Budding dramaturge, may your propitious appearance counteract the tragedy of Stephanie Gingrich's sudden recusal. An emergency, she says.
Ward.
Stephanie was our lion of the light board, but platitudinal though it may be, the show must sojourn forth.
That dude is weird. I've already seen what happens when Rachel plays with fire. Rachel plus swords should be fun. No way in hell I'm going up on that stage.
David's... Garden, or did David dig Doug's?
Hey, Dana.
Did Doug dig David's garden, or did David dig Doug's? Did Doug dig
Hell
David's garden?
Know.
Or did David? Did Doug dig David's garden? Or did David dig Doug's?
After all the work Steph did, it's amazing that she would drop everything to be there for Mikey.
Did Doug dig David's garden? Or did David dig Doug's?
Hey, Samantha.
Shh.
Nathan, please.
I can't do it, Dad. I'm sorry.
Keep your voice down.
You don't understand. They all hate me. They're just gonna laugh at me. And the football team will just bully me more.
Why do you suppose that is?
I don't know.
Because you show weakness. Just like you're doing right now.
But, Dad...
When will you learn that this isn't about you and your problems? This is about the Prescott name. My name. You will not embarrass me. Nathan.
Yes.
Good. Now. Break a leg. I'll see you after the show.
Great pep talk, Mr. P. Everyone knows the best way to instill confidence in someone is by intimidating them.
I don't know who you are, but mind your own business.
I'd love to. Don't you have, like, a private bunker filled with gold coins where you could have these conversations?
Nathan.
Fuck!
Boys changing tent. Thanks, but no thanks. Rachel?
Did Doug.
Whatever that was, it was shady as shit. I need to find whatever Victoria slipped into that drink. Muscle relaxers?
Coming, Rachel?
Hurry now before your tea gets... What are you doing here? This area is for cast and crew only. Or are you only here to try and sabotage the play like you sabotaged my homework? God, you're pathetic.
I'm here to support Rachel.
How nice.
I want to make sure she's relaxed before the show.
Whatever. Oh, Rachel Amber. It was customary among the thespians of ancient Greece for the understudy to offer hot tea to the lead actress on opening night. As a way of showing appreciation for her tutelage. It is in that spirit that I offer you this beverage. May it help to reveal the essence of your talents for all to see.
Wow. That, thanks. Wait up, Rachel. Bitch, dosed your tea.
Excuse me? How dare you?
Victoria, could this... possibly be true?
Of course not. A dropout Chloe is clearly directing her misplaced anger at me. I'm sorry your life is a mess, but it's not my fault, okay?
Chloe, Victoria is my friend. She would never do anything to sabotage me. Then she should prove it. Drink the tea.
What?
I wouldn't dare insult Victoria's integrity like that. Then again, if that's what it'll take to convince you that Victoria is a good and caring person, fine. Come on, Vic. Put dropout Chloe in her place once and for all.
Happy?
So happy.
Whatever. If you're done accusing me of things, I'll just be on my way. Bitches.
Wow. Saved my ass again, Price. All in a day's work. And this has been a particularly batshit crazy day.
Oh, hey, that's mine.
The gloomiest shirt of the bunch. How did I know you were gonna pick that one? I guess Prospera knows all.
Sweet tarnation, we're ruined. The show is ruined.
That was quick.
My dear young artists, a misfortune most unkind has befallen us. Juliet is waylaid. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our Ariel. Would that she could but manifest on her master's whim as a true spirit. Alas, devoid of an understudy, the situation is a dire one indeed. I'm afraid we may have to cancel. Truly, we are a cursed lot. Even my prodigious imagination cannot conceive of a worse turn of fate.
Ah!
Touché.
What?
No.
Mr. Keaton.
No.
Chloe could step in for Juliet.
No fucking chance.
At least until the road's clear.
The romantic.
She's the right fit for Juliet's costume.
She is indeed. Tell me, my dear, have you ever acted before?
Hell no.
She's being modest. We play improv games all the time. And she's fantastic at it.
My dear, what if I told you that the entire fate of the production rests upon your slender shoulders?
I'd say you're super fucked.
Chloe, please. For me.
Damn it. I can't believe Rachel's talked me into this. I seriously have to memorize all of this? Thanks, Rachel.
When life gives you lipstick, use it to tag shit. Got it. Why does it feel like Steph is mocking me from afar?
By accident, most strange, bountiful fortune hath mine enemies brought to this shore.
Here, cease more questions. Thou art inclined to sleep. 'Tis a good dullness, and give it way. I know thou canst not choose.
Come away, servant. Come.
Ah, shit. I'm on.
Oh, that's you.
I am ready now.
Get up there.
Approach, my Ariel. Come.
Damn it. No problem. I've got this. I just walk to Rachel and say my line. All hail, great mistress. I come to answer thy best pleasure.
Most fearless, generous spirit. Hast thou performed to point the tempest that I bade thee?
I boarded the king's ship. In every cabin, I flamed amazement. The fire and cracks of sulfurous roaring, the most mighty Neptune seemed to besiege and make his bold waves tremble.
My brave spirit. Who was so firm, so constant, that this coil would not infect his reason?
Not a soul. The king's son, Ferdinand, was the first man that leaped from his ship and cried, hell is empty and all the devils are here.
Yes! But are they, Ariel, safe?
All right. I guess this is when I'm supposed to walk somewhere.
Not a hair perished. And as thou badest me, I have dispersed them about the inn. Troops!
Bravo!
Ariel, thy charge exactly is performed, but there's more work.
Is there more toil? Let me remember thee what thou hast promised.
How now? What is't thou canst demand?
My liberty.
Indeed.
Thy liberty? Nay, this most of all I will not grant.
That's not her line, is it? What's going on?
But thou assured my freedom, didn't thou? I never said how dearly I hold thee. My habit's been to keep my soul well draped. Most loyal spirit, companion, and friend. Is acting in my service not replete with excitement, amusement, and delight?
Of course, mistress. Most truly, it is so.
Mr. Keat, they're way off script.
It's magical.
Then why, I pray you, wish you to be free?
Excitement's a mere counterfeit of bliss. These storms and these adventures, I prefer to know
thou still cared for my plainest self.
I have thee in my grasp. I will not bend. I will not see thee flying forth alone. The envy would be more than I could bear.
So come with me. Is that not in thy power?
Spirit, take my hands. Most faithful friend, for but a little longer I beseech. Continue in thy service to my schemes, and when they are complete, I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle. The corners of the world are mere prologue. I'll seek to make thy happiness so great that e'en the name of liberty's forgot. What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish?
Say yes!
Yes, I am most pleased.
Your duty done for now, so go forth hence with haste.
I've work to do.
You crushed it. So good.
You're a born thespian, my dear. I'll be chasing you down next year. And the ending, absolutely transformative. I am humbled.
Thanks. What the hell just happened?
The strangeness of
was
your
that
story
real?
Put heaviness in me.
Shake it off. Come on. We'll visit Caliban, my slave.
Tis a villain, sir. I do not love to look on.
He does make our fire, fetch in our wood. What ho! Slave! Caliban! Come forth,
come
I say!
On! As wicked do as e'er my mother brushed.
Thou poisonous slave, got by the devil himself, filth as thou art. I have lodged thee in mine own cell, till thou didst seek to violate the honor of my child.
Shit.
He's crying. Fetch us in fuel, and be quick. So, slave, hence.
Fuck you.
Where should this music be? In the air or the earth?
Oh, thank God.
This play is super intense.
What is it? A spirit? It carries a brave form, but it is a spirit.
No, wench. It eats and sleeps and hath such senses as we have.
I will resist such entertainment.
Put thy sword up, traitor.
Do you love me?
O heaven, O earth, bear witness to this sound. I, beyond all limit of what else in the world, do love, prize, honor you.
His tears run down his beard like winter's drops from eaves of reeds.
Go release them, Ariel. My charms I'll break. Their senses I'll restore, and they shall be themselves. Now my charms are all overthrown, and what strength I have's mine own. Pray, release me from my bands with the help of your good hands.
fun?
You're so dead.
Yeah? How dead?
Hella dead.
God, Keaton's face behind you when you walked on stage? I was shitting myself. He was shitting himself.
That dude owes me.
My dear, what if I told you that the entire fate of our production rests upon your slender shoulders? I've never had an experience like that on stage. Yeah, right? You
know,
you. Like, seriously, I love nights after a show.
Is it always like this?
Oh, totally. It's such a high. No more nerves, just the adrenaline. So, first timer, are you proud of yourself? You were literally perfect tonight. I was blown away. Yeah, I feel really awesome. If you told me this morning I'd be this happy tonight, you've gone through so much shit today.
Right now's pretty good. Okay, the whole show was good. I admit it.
Yeah. It was magical. Let's leave. For real.
For real, huh?
You said you wanted to skip town and never look back. Like I said last night, let's do it.
I know. I've been thinking about that all day. But that was...
Don't say it was just a crazy thought. You mean it. I can tell. You want this.
Yeah, but, like, eventually.
Let's go... Now. Didn't we already agree on stage?
We can't just...
Why not?
I know our parents have been shitty, but we can't just leave them.
That doesn't sound like Chloe Price.
But... I'm the only one my mom has left. You're right. What am I saying? She's got David now.
Fine then, drama queen. Where are we going? You tell me. What uniquely twisted location does Chloe Price plus Rachel Amber equal?
Why don't you show me L.A.?
Perfect. 60 degrees every night. You and me on the Santa Monica Pier. Gorging on food truck food. Smoking up. Looking at the moon shining on the waves.
and a beautiful blonde man will sit next to us and smile at you.
Yeah, okay.
He'll say, I like your eyes. And I'll say, back off. She's with me.
You're full of shit.
I love this time of night. Don't you just feel like everything's possible?
Rachel, stop. If you don't mean this, it's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen.
For fuck's sake! I've never been more serious in my life. Chloe, what would it take to convince you?
How about, is that convincing enough?
Yeah.
Holy shit. Right? What is this stuff? I think it's a sign. I think we should leave tonight.
Really?
If you want to, I'm ready. Let's go sneak some clothes and stuff for my house.
For you or for me?
I gotta say, my clothes look damn good on you.
Cool. Let's do it.
And then we'll get the hell out of Arcadia Bay.
That sounds perfect.
Oh, you're home. Rose, Rachel's home. And she brought her new friend.
Our star returns. You're just in time. Dinner's almost ready. Chloe, was it?
It was, but that was before I was expelled. Now, it's that girl who used to go here. What was her name again? All one word.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to bring up any sore subjects.
Who's sore?
Rachel, honey, you were resplendent tonight.
Thanks.
Chloe, you must join us for dinner tonight.
She must? I must?
Of course.
I made chicken a la king. I'm sure you both acted up quite the appetite.
Thanks, but I was just gonna stop in for a sec and then bounce.
Oh, did you have other dinner plans?
Dinner plans? I always thought dinner was something that just sort of happens.
Chloe, I know we didn't exactly meet each other at our best this morning, but with you and Rachel becoming such fast friends, I insist you join us for dinner. Don't you agree, Rachel?
Yes, of course. Chloe, would you join us for dinner, please? Of course. Great. I just need to wash off. Then I'll be right down.
Don't be long. In meantime, perhaps you can help me with the table, Chloe?
Sure thing, Mrs. Amber. Okay, I'm gonna go pack. After dinner, we can make our break. You cool down here? Totally. Your parents love me. They're good at coming off that way, but don't let your guard down. And, Chloe, we just need to make it through dinner. Try not to say anything that, you know... that I would normally say. Exactly. Just some quality time with the Ambers. What could possibly go wrong? Rachel really was an overachiever before she met me. Glad I nipped that in the bud. How many cabinets do you need? Everything about this house is nicer, cleaner, better, and more expensive than mine. Damn. Wonder if this is a family heirloom. Oh, I think that's an original Who Gives a Shit. Rachel and I both had great childhoods. Mine just ended a little before hers, I guess. Solved it. Something about this photo doesn't seem right. I should fix it. Can't tag this while Rachel's mom is right there. She totally bust me. Hey there, Mrs. Amber.
Chloe, I'm so glad you're joining us tonight. You borrowed that shirt from Rachel. We call it the Rorschach shirt. What do you see?
I guess I see a bird.
Interesting. Well, wash it before you bring it back.
So, Rachel was pretty awesome tonight.
Yes, she was. Though, to be fair, she's pretty awesome every night. I wish I were half as driven when I was her age.
Me too.
I get the sense that you're a force of nature yourself. I can see why the two of you get along so well.
You can? Because it still seems crazy to me. So, you putting me to work or what?
Yes. If you could please take 4 plates from the cupboard and set them on the table.
What if I can't?
Excuse me?
You said if I could. Never mind.
You're a riot, Chloe.
All right, Chloe. You've set the table without ruining someone's marriage before. Piece of cake. No skeletons. Lots of shiny dishes, though. It's off to the table with you. Glasses. Damn, the ambers are fancy as shit.
Yes, Chloe?
Plates? Check. Anything else?
Actually, could you be a dear and ask Mr. Amber what he'd like to drink with dinner?
I will be a dear. Talking to James. As long as I can avoid using the words cheating and scumbag, I should be fine. I should stay down here until Rachel is ready. Hiya, Mr. Amber.
Chloe, what can I do for you?
What's your vice, Mr. Amber?
I'm sorry?
Your wife wants to know what kind of drink you're having.
Ah, let's say sherry.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, sherry.
Comical. Chloe, maybe you can help me understand something.
I'll give it a shot.
Rose and I, we're worried about Rachel. Yesterday was so unlike her. What do you suppose is going on?
Besides all my bad behavior rubbing off on her, you mean?
Another joke.
You tell me. It seemed like you and Wells were happy to believe that this morning.
And you were all too eager to play into our expectations. In my experience, that's a tactic people use to cover for someone else. Rachel is her own person. She's responsible for her actions. I'd be lying if I said I didn't have concerns about your friendship, but perhaps you're exactly who Rachel needs right now as she navigates the choppy waters of adolescence.
Thanks.
Yes, Chloe?
The boss man would like a sherry.
Thank you. The glasses are in the china cabinet. You can place one at his setting.
How am I supposed to get to China? Kidding. It's the fancy-looking cabinet, right?
You got it. It's the triangle-shaped one.
Basic shapes. Now you're speaking my language.
Yes, Chloe?
What else? Feel like I'm getting good at this.
Only one last step. As our guest, you may do the honor of lighting the candles. The lighter is in the...
It's cool. I've got my own.
Oh.
You never know when you'll need to light a candle. Right?
You are a paragon of preparedness.
Thanks. I think... Time to light some candles and bless this joint up a bit. Finally, Mrs. Amber has her back turned. Time to fix this photo.
We're good.
The Amber family and fire. What could possibly go wrong?
So, Chloe, are you and Rachel in any of the same classes?
I wish. Rachel's all honors. I'm still trying to get into remedial... What's it called? Vocabulary.
What about that fire?
Dinner's really good, Mom.
Thank you, Rachel. The way the fire spreads so fast, I've never heard of anything like it.
It's almost surreal. They say a fire like that could only come from a crime of passion.
Passion? What does that mean?
I don't know. You tell me. 'Cause you're the DA, of course.
It's certainly troubling. The latest report from the commissioner's office suggests arson.
Arson? Why would anyone do that?
Any number of reasons. With everything going on in the world today, even a town like Arcadia Bay isn't immune to the ills of society.
I cannot imagine how difficult these last few years have been for you, Chloe. Now that you and Rachel have become friends, I want you to know that our home is always open to you.
Cool. Thanks.
Well said, dear. It's imperative in such troubled times as these that we remember what is most important to us. Family. Family's not merely a gift. It is a responsibility. As such, those we love must be cared for and never, ever taken for granted.
Enough of this asshole. Rachel may have to take it, but I don't. I'm going to turn his daughter and wife against him at his own dinner table. I'm not sure I agree, James.
Oh? I thought you of all people would be grateful for family, at least.
If you ask me, gratitude is just one more way privileged people tell the unprivileged that they should be happy with what they have.
That is an excellent point, Chloe. We must always be sensitive to the way our privileges shape our perspectives.
Well said, Mom.
Still, there must be some room for personal responsibility. I'm sure you agree, Chloe.
When my mom's boyfriend talks about responsibility, it's always code for him trying to control other people. Guess that's why they teach it in the army.
See? This is why it's so important to invite diverse voices to converse with one another. It's absolutely stimulating.
Highly stimulating.
Since you have answers for everything, Chloe, perhaps you'd like to enlighten us with some of your hard-earned wisdom about the world.
Sure. I believe there's always darkness in this world, and it usually comes from the people we thought we could trust.
Very well articulated, Chloe. I am consistently impressed with how politically aware your generation is.
Chloe is an excellent articulator.
Excuse me, dear? But if this is what passes for politically aware these days, we're in serious trouble.
James, that's unfair and also rude to Chloe.
No, I don't believe it is. It seems clear that these points Chloe is making are merely veiled attacks on me.
I keep everything on the level. Unlike this one guy I know, whose name rhymes with Schmames Schmamber. Don't worry, Mr. Amber. I can tell that my progressive attitude is not welcome in this house. I'll see myself out.
James, Chloe is right. You owe her an apology.
I owe her no such thing. I believe she is willfully acting belligerently, just as she did this morning. It is how people like her respond to adversity.
People like her? So we're profiling now? This is what 8 months in the DA's office has taught you.
I resent that. My office is committed to fair and equitable treatment.
Yes, I've read the press releases.
Excuse me? Are you calling me a hypocrite? Rachel!
I can't sit here and listen to this bullshit anymore.
Rachel!
Stop it, Dad. You're a hypocrite, okay? I know. You lying, cheating, piece of shit, motherfucker.
Excuse me?
We saw you yesterday at the Overlook.
James?
Kissing that woman.
James.
Rachel, honey, whatever you saw or think you saw, I know it's hard, but I need you to trust me.
Think we saw? Are you trying to gaslight us? There's no thinking involved. We saw you locking lips with some other woman. Best part is, she and I use the same drug dealer.
That's enough. You are not welcome here or around my daughter any longer. I know exactly what kind of person you are from the moment I saw you, and I let my wife's compassion get the better of
you. Oh? What kind of person is that?
A delinquent. A broken girl from a broken home.
That's enough, James. I will not have you continue to speak to her like this.
truth! Stop lying! Stop being a politician for one fucking minute! Can't you just be my dad?
Rachel, that woman you saw, that wasn't my mistress. That was your mother.